So, welcome to the session Radiology, the Diagnosis of Tuberculosis. I am Dr. Chitra Kumar. Since time immemorial, TB has been a phenomenal foe to mankind, causing high morbidity and mortality. So, early diagnosis of tuberculosis is mandatory for effective treatment and control of TB. But relying on the conventional sputum microscopy and microbiological culture tests, which are less sensitive in passy bacillary and early stages of disease, lead to inherent delay in the diagnosis and treatment of TB. So, imaging plays a major role in screening, diagnosing and follow up of patients put on treatment for TB. Role of chest radiograph in TB. Chest X-ray is an essential tool for early detection of pulmonary tuberculosis. Abnormal chest X-ray is an indication for full diagnostic evaluation for TB, including bacteriological diagnostic test. X-ray is an important tool for childhood TB diagnosis with history, evidence of TB infection and microbiological test. CXR can be used to triage who should be tested with gene expert to reduce the number of individuals to be tested and also to improve the pretest probability for TB and predictive value for gene expert. It can assist the diagnosis of TB among people living with HIV. It helps to rule out active TB before treating latent TB infection. CXR is an essential technology for TB prevalence survey to identify survey participants eligible for bacteriological examination. So, we divided the session into the following days. First, we are going to start the interpretation of the normal chest X-ray. While interpreting an X-ray, a systematic approach with sound knowledge of chest anatomy and pathology is essential to gain optimal diagnostic information and to avoid potential error in interpretation. Before reading an X-ray, first we have to check the ownership, age, date and side marking. This is known as a pre-read. Next, we have to check whether it is a type of X-ray, whether it is a PA or lateral. Then we have to check the quality control of the X-ray, that is penetration, inspiration, rotation and angulation. Next, we have to start interpreting the findings of the X-ray, like soft tissue, bony structures, mediastinum, diaphragm and lung fields. Before starting interpretation of the X-ray, first we have to check whether it is a right film for the right patient. Then you check the name, age and sex. Sometimes name may be shared by many individuals. So, we have to look for date of birth and hospital number. Then side marking is also important. A misplaced side marker is more common than the true dextrocardia. Then there have been chest reports of insertion of the ICD on the wrong side of pneumothorax because of a false side marking. Then we have to check the type of the X-ray, whether it is a PA view, AP view, lateral view or lateral decubitus. So, this is a normal PA view. It is the most frequently requested and useful radiological examination of the chest. Patient is made to stand erect and shoulders are adducted and rotated forward to displace the scapula away from the lung fields. X-ray passes from posterior to anterior and the exposure is made on full inspiration for optimal visualization of the lung bases. The PA view do not exaggerate the size of the heart. Coming to penetration, penetration is the degree to which the X-ray has passed through the body a optimal penetrator X-ray, we should able to see the rib through the heart and the interorbital disc barely seen through the heart, and we should also able to see pulmonary vessels nearly to the edges of the lung. So, this X-ray shows a over penetrated film. Here the lung fields are darker than normal, so they may obscure the subtle pathologies. You can see the spine beyond the diaphragm and leads to inadequate lung detail. So, the over penetration X-ray leads to under reporting, and this is the under penetration. Here the emit diaphragms are obscured and pulmonary markings are more prominent than they are actually are. So, here it leads to over diagnosis. So, next is inspiration. Conventionally all the X-ray have been acquired in a erect posture in a maximal inspiratory phase. To assess the degree of inspiration, we have to count conventionally the rib from top to bottom. In a normal X-ray, we should be able to count 9 ribs, 9 to 10 posterior ribs. The diaphragm should intersect between 9th and 10th posterior ribs. Heart shadow should not be hidden by the diaphragm. This X-ray showing poor inspiration. Poor inspiration could crowd the vascular markings and cause pseudo airspace opacity. This is X-ray taken at the maximum inspiration. With better inspiration, the disease process at the lung base has cleared. Rotation means the patient was not positioned flat on the X-ray film. In a properly placed patient, the medial ends of the both clavicle are equidistant from the midline or spinous process of the vertebral bodies. So, here they say rotation to right, the spinous process appear away to the left clavicle. So, the patient is rotated toward their own left side. It is a rotation to right, the spinous process appear away to right clavicle, the patient is rotated towards their own side. Angulation, in a properly angulated X-ray, the patient is made to stand erect, then X-ray passes from posterior to anterior in a horizontal line without any angulation, either tilted up or down, centering at T5. In a properly angulated film, the clavicle should lay over posterior third rib. This is a lordotic view where there is a angulation, the X-ray tube has been tilted up. So, in a lordotic view, there is a distortion of the heart and diaphragm. Then after verifying the quality of the X-ray, then we have to start interpreting the findings. First, we have to concentrate on the soft tissue and bony structures. So, first we have to look for any bony abnormality. So, we have to check the ribs, we have to look for clavicle, you look for the scapula. So, this X-ray showing is a missing ribs. So, the ribs are missing and the clavicle is missing. So, this is a patient known as a spindle deformity, where it is a the scapula is placed in a higher position. This is a congenital problem. So, X-ray can detect the abnormality, but however, MRI is very useful to confirm the extent of pathology. And this is a pectus excavatum. Here there is a backward displacement of the sternum. So, here the posterior aspect of ribs are more horizontal and anterior ribs are more vertical. So, it looks like a figure of 7. So, because of the displacement, the heart is being tilted on left side and produce a straight line, and there is a silhouetting of the right cardiac body also. Next, this is a soft tissue abnormality. In this X-ray, the right side there is a increased lucency. Here there is a absence of breast and mal development of the pectoral major. The syndrome is known as a Poland syndrome. The second X-ray, where we can see the calcified nodes in the subcutaneous place. It is more seen in a calcification of the nodes in a tuberculosis patient. Next, we have to see the mediastinal structures. The upper part of the mediastinum, this is of the trachea. The tracheal, we have to see the tracheal shadow, cardiac shadow, and a mediastinal contour. First, you have to inspect the tracheal shadow and superior mediastinum. Trachea occupy in the superior mediastinum, it appear as a translucent band. So, it lie midway between the two clavicle, it extends from neck into the chest. The lower end of the trachea, there is a deviated to the right side. This is a normal. Then the mediastinal width is also more important. The upper mediastinal width should not exceed more than 6 centimeter. If it is more than 6 centimeter, so there is a, you have to suspect this would be a AP view or mediastinal enlargement or any structures, abdominal, AP window or any unfolding of aorta, all will lead to widening of the upper mediastinum. Next, you have to assess the heart and the lower mediastinum. So, heart is positioned in the lower mediastinum, 2/3 of the heart is on the left side and 1/3 of the heart is on the right side. You have to compare the density of the heart, it should be equal on both sides, and the right cardiac border is formed by the right atrium and left cardiac border is formed by the left ventricle. So, when the poor distinction of the right cardiac border, we can suspect right middle lobe disease, and when the lingular left cardiac border is silhouetted, we get in a left lower lingular consolidation. And in dextrocardia, 2/3 of the heart is on the right side, but the apex is important. In true dextrocardia, the apex is facing towards the left side. In pseudo dextrocardia, the apex is oriented to the right side. Next, you have to check the diaphragm. There are two diaphragm, right diaphragm and left diaphragm. So, right diaphragm is slightly higher than the left, and we have to check the sharpness of the borders. Doom lies in the midclavicular line between 5th and 7th anterior rib, and we have to check the free air, gastric bubble and pleural effusion. The left diaphragm, the lower than the right because of the constant thrust of the left ventricle. Next, coming to the lung fields, the radiologically lung fields have been divided into zones, upper zone, mid zone and lower zone. The upper zone starts from the apex to the lower end of the anterior second rib. The mid zone starts from the lower end of second rib to the fourth rib, and mid zone, the lower zone starts from the fourth rib to the diaphragm, and the zones do not equate the lung lobe, because on the left side there are three lung zones, but there are the lobes are only two. So, whenever you have to describe a opacity, you have to describe in related to the lung zones, not the lobe. Coming to the lung fields, the only structures seen are vessels, end on airways and some fissures. vessels branch and decrease progressively in size. Upper vessels are smaller than lower zone vessel, but it is reversed in pulmonary vascular hypertension. Coming to the fissures, fissures divide the lung into lobes and help to determine the boundaries of the lobe. Left major fissure separates the left upper lobe from the left lower lobe. Right major fissure separates the right upper lobe from right middle lobe from the right lower lobe, and right minor fissure separates the right upper lobe from right middle lobe. So, here is an horizontal fissure. It looks like a hairline thickness in a PA view. So, horizontal fissure alone is seen in a frontal view because it is tangential to the X-ray beam. It runs from the hilum to sixth vertebra in the axillary line. So, displacement of the fissure indicates volume change in the right side. Next is an oblique fissure. Usually oblique fissure is not seen in the frontal view. So, it is seen only in the lateral because it is parallel to the X-ray. It starts at T4 or T5 and runs downwards and cuts the hilum obliquely and reaches the diaphragm. So, here the frontal view showing the, you can see the oblique fissure. Usually oblique fissure is not depicted in the PA view, but when there is a underlying lung is diseased, we can see the oblique fissure. It is the lower upper lip of the oblique fissure, and here it is a oblique fissure. This is X-ray showing right lower lobe collapse. In a right lower lobe collapse, the oblique fissure come into the picture. Next is a hilum. Hilum comprises vessels, arteries and veins, airways and lymph nodes. The density of the hilum is mainly due to the vessel. It is a V-shaped structure. The upper lip of the V is formed by the superior pulmonary vein, and the inferior limb of the hilum is formed by the descending pulmonary artery. Both are intersect from the hilar point. Right hilum is slightly lower than the left. So, any distortion of the hilum indicates the pathology in the lung. Now, after completing the interpretation, we have to check whether we have completed the review interpretation of the hidden area or review area. So, these are the important area, is called apical area, hilar and retrocardiac and retrodiaphragmatic area. So, any pathology in the left posterior lobe you can see in the retrocardiac area, and apical lesions, for example, acicose fissure, we have to concentrate on the apical area, and any opacity in the retrodiaphragm, this could be due to lower lobe consolidation. Next, coming to the lordotic view, it is usually the optional, it is not routinely done. If you want to see the epicysts, you can order for a lordotic view. It is nothing but it is an AP view. So, in a lordotic view, the apical infiltration, nodules, cavity, calcifications, acicose lobe, middle lobe collapse are clearly demonstrated. Now, we can see the cavity in a apical area. It is clearly seen in a lordotic area because this is a small area is be covered by the clavicle and the ribs. So, by positioning in the lordotic view, the two clavicle is being shifted superiorly. So, you can able to see the clearly see the apical area. Thank you. With this, we are finishing the interpretation of the normal chest X-ray. Thank you.